Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain polarization of dielectric slab. Before we go to the main topic, let me start with polarization of a nonpolar medium, a nonpolar atom. Suppose this is a nonpolar atom in which the center of gravity of negative charges and positive charges coincide. This is the center of gravity of the negative charges and also the center of gravity of the positive charge. So the dipole moment here is zero, so it is nonpolar. If we apply electric field, this electric field will repel this positive charge on this side, and it will pull the negative side and the negative charges on this side towards left. So it means they are polarized, this side negative and this side positive. And also the atom is stretched like this. That is the polarization of nonpolar atom. Now the dipole moment is not zero anymore. Let us go to the main topic, polarization of dielectric slab. Let us consider two plates, two metal plates A and B, this side A, this side B, having the same area. Surface area is A, both has same surface area A, and surface charge density, suppose this is positive charge. It is given positive charge, and plate B, the left face of plate B is filled with negative charge. So this will be the surface charge density of plate A, this will be surface charge density of plate B. Let us consider the distance between the two plates is D, and there is nothing between the two plates. It means it is vacuum. So there will be electric field. These are electric lines of force. We have uniform electric field inside the or the space between the two plates. E naught is given by the magnitude of E naught is given by surface charge density divided by epsilon naught. Let it be equation 1. This is surface charge density of either plate, and this is permittivity of free space. It was proved in Gauss' law, but it is in deleted portion for this year. Now the space between the two plates is filled with a dielectric medium of thickness, a dielectric slab of thickness D, so it will completely fill the space. We consider the thickness is D, actually it fills the space completely. This is dielectric slab, dielectric, and it will be polarized. So negative charges will be attracted by this positive side, and this side will be positive again, minus plus, minus plus. These are the atoms inside the dielectric. These are the atoms inside the dielectric. So they are all polarized. Since they are polarized, this negative and this positive, the neighbor, this positive side cancel with the neighboring negative charge. They cancel each other, they cancel each other, they cancel their effect. So we have only this. We can say that negative charge induced in this side minus qi plus qi, this side plus qi, they are induced charge. The net charge inside this the dotted line is zero. They cancel their effect each other. So because of this charge qi on this side and minus qi on this side, it produces electric field along this. That is electric field due to polarization. This electric field is electric field due to polarization. It is denoted by EP, electric field due to polarization. So the resultant field will be E naught, that is in air, E naught minus EP. This is also called it is also called reduced field. Okay. Here we have the slab which has dielectric constant kappa. That kappa is equal to E naught by E. So from this expression we know that E naught is greater than E, so kappa is always greater than 1. Now the volume of the slab will be area into thickness. Volume of the slab is area into thickness of the slab, and PI, that is dipole moment due to induced charges, minus Q and plus QI, they are equal and opposite, so it forms a dipole. The dipole moment will be QI, either charge into distance of separation, D. In the previous chapter, we use 2A instead of D. Here we use the thickness of the slab. Now let me define polarization density. Polarization density is given by capital P. That is, since it is density, polarization density is dipole moment per unit volume. Dipole moment per unit volume. So dipole moment is qi d, and the volume is ad. D and d cancel, we have qi by a. In your notebook I wrote qi by d, that was a mistake, it has to be a, make correction. So we have p equals to qi by A, that is surface charge density, that is polarization surface charge density. So we have polarization density is equal to polarization surface charge density. we can also write the reduced field as Q, sorry, sigma minus sigma P. This is in air, and this is in this is because of polarization divided by epsilon naught. So it is sigma by epsilon naught minus sigma P by epsilon naught. Sigma P by epsilon naught is, oh, we can replace this one. Oh, this is the electric field in vacuum. This one, it is electric field in vacuum. So E is electric field in vacuum minus sigma P is equal to polarization density divided by epsilon naught. It is found that the polarization density is directly proportional to what? It is directly proportional to the reduced field, such that the constant of proportionality is chi e into epsilon naught. Chi e is electric susceptibility, and so this is E, this is the constant of proportionality. Chi E, E naught is constant of proportionality. So we can write this equation as E equals to E naught minus P is chi E, E naught epsilon naught E by epsilon naught. Then we can sell this out. So we have E equals to E naught minus chi E into E, taking this on this side, E plus chi E, E equals to E naught. Here we take common, E as common, 1 plus chi E equals to E naught. This is reduced field. This is the electric field in air, in vacuum. Okay, so 1 plus chi E equals to E naught by E. E naught by E is the dielectric constant, this one. So we have proved that 1 plus chi E equals to dielectric constant kappa. It is also denoted as epsilon R, relative permittivity. They are same. Kappa, dielectric constant, and E, epsilon R, that is relative permittivity. Okay.